it's the Shitcase Cinema.
There's a kid out there using his car to kill people.
The Wraith. I don't know why it's called The Wraith, so let's find out. So meet the star of the movie, the one and only Charlie Sheen, when he was young and not claiming to have tiger blood or be winning all the time.
Winning?
So he plays Jake and he cruises on into town looking like the stud that he is, and he goes to the local lake where all the cool people hang out. He's basically gone to perv on the half-naked girls, let's be honest. He makes friends with this guy called Billy. Billy is good friends with the girl that Jay is perving over, and she used to date his brother before he died. It's so tragic, it's so Shakespeare. She also has this crazy guy who is obsessed with her.
Packard gets crazy jealous if anybody even looks at Carrie cross-eyed. You gotta wear dark glasses so he doesn't catch you at it.
Clearly your glasses aren't dark enough as he's just spotted you, although you're not being very subtle about it, Charlie boy. So Packard is basically the town's bad guy. He has his own gang of classic looking goons that he bosses around, and his main evil plan is racing against strangers and then stealing their cars when he wins. Such an evil bastard. Aside from being friends, Billy and Kerry both work at the same burger joint. So when their shift is over, Billy's about to give her a lift home, because he's a really nice guy, but oh no, evil Packard shows up with his gang of goons, and guess what? He wants Billy's car.
What's this triumph worth?
You're not getting it, Packard.
We're gonna race for it.
Look, Pack, you don't get my car. And if you're not nice, you're not gonna get your burgers with the mayo in Thousand Island the way you love them.
Whoa, that is how to deal with bullies, telling him that he won't get his burgers cooked the way he likes them. This is priceless. But before trouble starts, a fancy futuristic looking car appears which grabs her attention.
I think he's going to the Sandy Bar. Let me take him this time.
All right, it's your turn, dude. Let's go!
So they race for what seems like a lifetime, but then suddenly the futuristic car is packed up and boom! They collide and the goon goes tumbling down the cliff before becoming a flaming wreckage. Oh, and the flashy car just magically appears and drives away. That has surely got to be Charlie Sheen.
Winning!
The cops turn up and they're not just regular cops, they're super dumb cops.
You think he made it?
Oh, I don't know, he might have a few bumps and grazes on him after experiencing this petty crash. You goon! What's that phrase from that film Cobra that I used to use many years ago? Oh yeah.
Pig.
You dumb pig! Moving on, the sheriff rocks up, played by Randy Quaid, and he sees the dead body.
Oh, that's ugly, God.
Not quite sure how he's only missing his eyes, something is very strange about this. Speaking of strange, there's a spaceman on top of the mountain watching the sheriff grilling the gang of goons. This film has everything. Packard tells Kerry that he loves her, but it turns out they're not in a relationship. He's actually just controlling her, and get this, he's the one who killed her boyfriend, aka Billy's brother, but nobody knows this except for Kerry. Why she never went to the police about it when it happened, I'll never know. And then Packard shows his devotion to her by cutting his hand. Okay. There you go, guys. Apparently that is how you impress a lady. This film is mental. Any ladies out there impressed? So it turns out when Packard and his gang aren't trying to race and steal cars, they work in a garage fixing cars. Now, don't worry. Despite lots of cars and racers on the go, you don't have to have any interest in cars or racing. It's not exactly a car movie. It's kind of like the Fast and the Furious films. What the fuck have they got to do with street racing nowadays? Aren't they superhero James Bond spies in space or some bollocks now? Anyway, I digress. Where was I? Ah, yes, working in the garage. So check this out. While working in the garage, the spaceman appears very dramatically, but nobody in the garage laughs, so it must just be me that finds this amusing. He proceeds to shoot the shit out of the cars, much to the annoyance of Packard, who actually doesn't really look annoyed in the slightest. So he shoots up more cars and equipment. Still no reaction. More shooting occurs, and finally we do get a reaction. Such a great cheesy villain. He's amazing. Oh, and the spaceman's identity is shown very quickly.
Dig.
That was super quick, so here it is again. Yep, it's our boy Charlie. So it's time for another race. And as you can guess, the exact same as before happens. Lots of driving, then the futuristic car is parked up and the bad guy crashes into him and explodes. And then Charlie's car magically returns. Another victory.
Winning.
But oh dear, the cops are onto him and have a roadblock set to trap him. Any guesses for how this will play out?
Pig.
Yep, just drive straight through the cop cars like a boss.
winning.
Absolutely, Charlie. Absolutely. Now is my top five random bullshit moments. Number one, Packard knows how to treat the ladies. Offering them a lift home after work is always a nice gesture to make.
Hey, Carrie, I'll pick you up later tonight, so do yourself a favor and be here.
Such a gentleman. Number two, if burger joints were this cool with 80s music blasting out and attractive servers zooming around on roller skates, I'd definitely be eating burgers more often. Number three, when we first meet Jake and Kerry, within seconds she instantly wants to hang out with him. It's normal to want a bike ride with a stranger you've known for less than 10 seconds. Oh yeah. Number four, Charlie can float away into the night sky because he's made of stars. Number five, every time Charlie kills bad guys, it shows this random item and it magically always disappears. Now my response every time was like the old geezer from my last review, trucks. And a bonus one, Randy Quaid loves sugar in his coffee. But I mean, come on lad, that's insane now. Splash of coffee with his sugar, more like. Anyway, Packard is talking to two of his comic book goons when suddenly Charlie Boy turns up out of the blue.
Holy shit, it's that kid!
Go on, lad. So this crash sends Packard into a graveyard where he gets the shock of his life. What does it mean? How's he managed to create a gravestone with his name on it? All it means is it's Spaceman Charlie up to his silly alien games. That's it. Then Packard goes back to his garage to hang out and do silly handshakes with his gang like nothing's just happened to him. Only such a cool villain could do that. He's easily up there with the best ever. Oh, and a note on his gang, they all have awesomely ridiculous names, such as...
Got it, boy.
Hey, Rughead.
You listen good, Skank.
Skank.
But now that there's that Wraith out there that killed Augie...
A what out there, man?
A Wraith, man! A ghost! An evil spirit, and it ain't cool!
Ah, so that's where the title comes from. He's a Wraith. I don't actually know what he is. He's a guy who's dressed in a spacesuit and he comes in a flashy car and he wants to kill goons and destroy their cars. I mean, he might be an alien for all I know. Now, what am I talking about? He's a Wraith. That's it. End of. Okay? Good. So the Wraith, as he's now known, why? Because it's the title of the movie, duh, drives along and blows up these two clowns and the entire garage. He's clearly not messing around now. What an absolute boss.
Winning.
Yeah, winning, Charlie. Calm down. There's some really nice big old school explosions in this film, which is something that is sorely lacking in movies today, and you can easily tell the difference between real and CGI. So, hats off to this film. Moving on, Packard goes along to the burger place and casually scoops up Kerry and puts her into his car. Burger boy Billy runs out to the rescue, but gets beaten up while everyone else just stands around watching. Then Burger boy Billy gets angry.
You bastard chicken shits! You let him take her!
This film has more cheese than what Billy serves up in his burgers. I love it. So Mr. Evil stops in the desert and gets upset when Kerry says,
Packard, you're pathetic.
But before he can show her who's boss, the Wraith...
What out there, man?
A Wraith, man!
...turns up and it's game on. Yeah, there's no big fight, don't get excited, it's just another fucking car race. So cue another long driving scene, trucks get destroyed, the cops are there, but... they aren't any use, obviously.
Big.
And the Wraith stands around in the road. Packard attempts to run him over. Suddenly he's a car now and they crash and explode. I'm just like, what? And of course, this thing glows and disappears. Huh? This is mental. So Spaceman Charlie goes to visit Kerry and reveals himself to her.
Jake.
You know who I am.
Jamie.
Sorry, what? Why would you instantly assume it's your dead boyfriend? As an audience member watching this film, it's quite easy to see that this is the angle the film is taking. But how she jumps to this conclusion and how she totally accepts it's her reincarnated boyfriend who's come back on a motorbike and has a flashy car and wears a shitty spacesuit and looks like Charlie Sheen is beyond me. Next he goes to see Burger Boy Billy and gives him his space car.
Hey Billy, instructions are in the glove compartment.
Whatever, you gimpoint. But this is my favourite moment.
Jake! Jake! Jamie!
And now suddenly he realises that it's his dead brother. What is going on? I mean, how did they just... oh, just don't care, don't worry about it, just carry on. So The Wraith is a dumb, cheesy, popcorn, action-packed, laughably acted 80s slice of randomness. There are so many questions, and honestly, I don't know if I'd like it or if it's giving me a brain tumour and I'm talking bollocks, but I'm going to give it above average 6 out of 10.
Winning.